What it do, y'all?
Hey, guys.
We're Embrace the Suck 21.
Yes, we are.
I'm Spencer.
And I'm Daniel.
Back at it with some football.
Hell yeah.
It's been a while since we've done some football on the channel.
Yes, it has.
Or soccer, as we call it.
Yes, soccer.
Let's see. What's the last one we did? It was the Brazil 1982 one.
Yes.
That was requested by one of our patrons.
That was very interesting.
Yeah.
You know, it's...
A lot of people say it was the day football died.
Yeah. Like, what?
Like, what are you talking about?
I'll put it... Every football club will have its moment, right? Mm-hmm. In the sun.
Yeah.
Everyone will.
Oh, yeah.
And so all those moments are very debatable.
Oh, yeah. You could say that the day football died was when Washington became the Commanders.
Oh, my God. I posted on their official channel.
Oh, yeah.
I posted. I was like, what the fuck are we going to command?
The commies. The
I'm just like, what the hell are we going to, besides like losing? Are we going to command losing? Oh, man. I'm so livid about that name. Like, fans wanted Red Wolves, Red Wings, Red anything, you know? And then Dan Snyder was like, no, we'll go with this bullshit name.
Yeah.
I'm officially done with Washington football.
Yeah.
I'm in the market for a new team, and no, it's not the Trash Birds. It will not be.
Yeah, but hopefully watching some beauty of football
yes.
will cleanse your mind of that.
I hope so.
Let's go. I think football is a matter of life and death. I don't like that attitude. I can assure them that it's much more serious than that.
Nice.
Billy My father Shank. Used to tell me, listen, God give to you the gift to play football. But if you don't practice, if you don't train, if you don't respect the other player, you're never going to be a good player. You must train, you must prepare yourself to respect the coach. This is my advice.
Can I say something real quick? I don't know who said it. I think it was a long time ago. Practice does not make perfect. Perfect practice makes perfect.
Yes.
That's key.
Mm-hmm.
If you're
gifted with the ability to play this kind of football, you should do perfect practice whenever you can.
Yeah. I mean,
and I'm sure these guys did.
Yeah, and you as an artist.
Yes.
You practice. No, perfect practice makes perfect.
Yes.
Especially your songs.
Uh-huh.
Perfect. It has to be perfect. Can't be less than perfect or else it won't sound right.
Yeah. And you never know who's watching.
Yep.
Someone better clip that one.
God, man.
That's beauty, man. That's content.
Dude.
Oh, my God.
Jesus. Zlatan Ibrahimovic. Robin, his legs are fresh. Ramos is out. Robin's trying to go around him. Still a chance for Ryan Robin. It's five! It's a landslide! Busca Neymar. Es buena para el brasileño. Madre mía! ¡Qué golazo! It's Bergkamp. That's magnificent. Moves inside Ronaldo.
Man, I watching these clips makes me want to go in a time machine, tell seventh grade Spencer, that was playing on a soccer team, to keep going at it because you might have the chance to do this stuff.
Yeah, I feel like I was forced to play soccer. That is why I didn't fall in love with soccer.
Mm-hmm.
And I pushed away. That's why. I was forced to play soccer, and I was like, I don't want to play soccer because you're forcing me.
Right.
Keep
in mind, we're two American boys here.
Yeah.
That have been raised on NFL.
Yeah.
And so, like, that soccer wasn't cool to us.
No, I mean, it just wasn't a thing. It realistically, yeah, growing up, it's like, hey, man, the boys' soccer team won the championships. You're like, we have a boys' soccer team?
Yeah, yeah. It's
unfortunately, that's...
It's not the captain that gets all the... of the soccer team that gets all the girls. It's the football quarterback.
Yeah.
And the basketball head person, whatever they're called.
Yes.
Not the soccer...
basketball head person. I love that position.
I don't know.
I am the basketball head person. I love that, though. But yeah, you're right. It was always like... you had the essentially the trinity of sports. You had baseball, football, American football, and did I say baseball?
Basketball.
Basketball.
Yeah.
Yeah. Those are the
three. That's the whole trinity. If you lived like more up north, like you could add hockey to that. If you lived further south, you add
wrestling
and motorsports.
Yes.
NASCAR.
Your high school had motorsports?
Small towns. Like,
oh my god, yeah, that's awesome!
I mean,
what?
And like, and then like the Mid-Atlantic specifically,
lacrosse.
To that,
yeah.
Soccer was nowhere on there.
It wasn't on the map.
No.
It was. We. Yeah.
But apparently, it's getting more popular. Like Nashville has a soccer team now and a soccer stadium now.
Yeah.
Austin, Texas, they do too.
I mean, it took us a while, but it's picking up steam.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, but I just love this because this compilation gives us the scenario.
Yeah.
It's not just dude scoring a goal. It's on who.
Yeah, yeah.
And I like that.
Yeah, this little bottom part, you can't really see it on the screen here. There you go. Now you can see it.
Yeah, because a lot of times compilations, they don't do justice to what's happening.
Yeah, but this one... is doing rather well.
Yes, it really is.
Yeah, so thank you.
Second Everton player to go into the book. Here's Salah, and still Salah. Oh, Mohamed Salah! How about that? On your Merseyside derby debut!
Right there.
I feel like there's equal parts fuck yeah and equal parts oh shit.
Yeah.
It's balanced.
It's controlled chaos.
Yes.
In that moment right there.
Usually if I find myself in that position, I've just slipped on ice and there's no glory in what I'm about to, like, I just land and break.
Yeah, let's chase the screen real quick. Right there.
Yes.
That's some oh shit right there.
Yeah, no, if you don't have a ball and you're just walking around town and you find yourself in that position, dude.
Yeah. Or I find myself in that position after some beers and I'm slipped on some ice and I'm luckily not about to feel what's about to come.
No, that's the goal.
Yeah.
That is the goal. Don't feel it. You'll feel it in the next morning and following week.
Oh yeah.
That right there. Holy crap. In order to be athletic enough to, one, know where the ball is, to time it right, and two, not to die.
Yeah.
My God.
Yeah.
Yeah. I fall walking down my steps. Like, I could not do this.
Oh, my God.
Oh, man.
All right, let's back it up a little bit before we get negative comments on us pausing it.
Yeah.
All right. And then Ronaldo! Oh! What a goal by Cristiano Ronaldo!
That's wild, dude.
That is insane.
Scoring a goal, not just a winning goal, but just a goal in a World Cup is like top feeling.
Yeah. Like that's better than sex.
You have to have maybe just 500 people on this earth that have done that. Or maybe less. Probably a lot less.
Yeah.
But living at one time,
mm-hmm.
there's probably around just 500 people that can say they've experienced that feeling of scoring a goal in the World Cup.
Yeah.
Now it goes to like maybe 20 of those who actually scored a winning goal in the World Cup.
Yeah.
I mean, that I couldn't imagine
yeah.
the amount of just joy that is, man, and yeah. pride. And I mean, on these, and like what we saw on these, it's a lot of these clubs' first wins.
Yeah.
That's
yeah.
up there, too.
Yeah. Or first in a long time.
Yes.
Like, I saw Man City, like, that was 2012 was their first one in like, a very long time.
That's crazy. Oh,
yeah.
That city must have erupted.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Rubbing it back! Is that what that said?
50 to 1? Hold on, let me back it up here.
Chances? Greece won the 2004 Euro. They were given a 150 to 1 chance. Wow.
Dang, Greece making it happen.
Talk about an underdog.
Man.
Holy shit.
It's done well. Robin is there! I am Robin! Charlie won it for Bayern Munich. In towards Gerrard. Hello. Hello. Hit by Smica. It's in. It's in. Vladimir Smica. 2 goals in 2 minutes for Liverpool. Miracles are possible. He saved it.
Losing 0-3 at halftime.
They came back and won. Holy crap.
Unreal. Unfreaking real.
The European Cup is returning to England and to Anfield. Liverpool are champions of Europe again.
I saw this. This was epic.
Fantastic goal.
And scored 5 goals in under 9 minutes.
That's a what? Lot in 9 minutes.
Dude, soccer or football, that's a just 5 to something is a high scoring game.
Yeah.
Cause I've watched matches go 0-0.
Mm-hmm.
Like but that's insane. Mm. Wow.
That's intense. I can see why it's included in this one.
Robert Lewandowski! Quatrième but pour Robert Lewandowski en l'espace de 6 minutes 20!
Centre de Mario Götze.
Ah! Ah! Incroyable! Incroyable quintuplé!
Nouvelle frappe! But naturel! Le doublé!
It's Neymar trying to feed it through!
Dele Alli. Can he play it across to Eriksen? Lucas Moura's running in now! Lucas Moura! Spurs are still in this! To Trippier, Llorente! And Onana has kept it out twice! Lucas Moura! Lucas Moura's done it again! Incredible!
Now, something I'm thinking about during all these moments, all these beautiful moments in football history, there has got to be at least one of them where it's some dumbass group in there saying things like, let's pretend we score a goal. Yeah!
But I, like,
or Jimmy Savile.
Yeah, that guy.
Your mom.
What? Yeah. But I feel like.